Today, I want to talk about two techniques that will help you create alignment in your engineering organization. The reason I want to cover this topic with you today is because recently I've been talking to many engineering leaders and they mentioned alignment as their biggest challenge in their day-to-day job. So I think it's a very, very interesting problem to tackle. Today, we'll talk about two techniques that will help you create alignment in your organization. First, architecture decision records, and second, request for comments. Let's start with architecture decision records. Architecture decision record is a document that team creates when they want to introduce a significant change to architecture or to the system. So for example, if you are introducing a new microservice to your platform and you are deciding which database to take, or you've already made the choice for a specific database, but it's not used elsewhere, it's very, very good approach when you document it, you put it on paper and you distribute the document around. It could be a page in your wiki, it could be a PDF or whatever. Usually it's just a page in the wiki, to be honest. So you distribute it around and then folks that are responsible for the entire platform from the architecture perspective, they could understand the context for the change and the reasoning behind the change you want to make, and then give you some advice, right? So this is a very useful approach, because if you need to go through some levels of approval, like I said, I want to introduce a new microservice to the platform, so chief architect at the organization need to say, yep, this looks good, let's move on. So having this document around actually solves two problems. It creates a context, a basis for the conversation between chief architect and the team. And then the second problem it solves, it communicates what you want to do, so that not just the two peers like know what's happening, your team and the chief architect, but also the, like every other team that's involved with the platform. So they know that team X will be working on the microservice Y and why it's happening and stuff like that. The second one, request for comments, is actually a little bit of the other way around. You create the document, but you don't distribute it in order to get approval. You share it purely because you are seeking for feedback. That's why it's called request for comments. You create a document that outlines a change. Team X wants to introduce a new microservice with a database behind it, with Elasticsearch index behind it, and blah, blah, blah. And this is needed because of X, Y, and Z. You put it on paper, you share it with every team you know, could be ops, could be other dev teams, architect teams, and stuff like that. But instead of seeking for approval or getting that approval from somebody, you actually like trying to convince folks to share feedback and tell you why you should change your mind. Because if they come back and say, look, Alex, you don't need to be using this database and this technology for this problem, because we already solved this problem and we have some internal solution inside the organization, it could be that I wasn't aware about this solution and hence introduce something new. But if this is a solved problem, I'd rather use a solution that's available in the organization. By creating this doc and sharing it with your entire organization, you are creating alignment between all of the teams involved and creating a like transparency process that helps everyone in the team. In this video, I've covered just one area that are really critical to get right in order to successfully deliver software on time, in a way that you can feel truly proud of, reducing risk and building up alignment along the way. If you want to learn more about other areas, subscribe to my channel.